Hello everyone, this lecture is about thermal expansion. We're going to learn some definitions and then go through some examples. So what is thermal expansion? Well, thermal expansion is the changing size or volume of a given mass with temperature due to molecular agitation. A very simple example and very common is the thermometer. In a thermometer, we have an increasing temperature around the thermometer and then in the liquid. This increasing temperature leads to an increasing molecular agitation, and this molecular agitation leads to an increase in the size or volume in the case of a thermometer. But how do we quantify this increase in volume or in size? Let's start with the linear thermal expansion. It's a one-dimensional expansion. We know that the variation in size, in length, for this example, depends on the initial length of the object, depends on which type of object, with which material we are dealing, and the variation in temperature. This coefficient of linear thermal expansion can be found in several tables. We have a lot of tables that give us this coefficient depending on each material. An example where you can see this linear thermal expansion, is in railroads. So in a railroad, we can despise the expansion in the other two dimensions because they are fairly small compared to the length of the railroad, and if we don't have space between each section of the railroad, we can have something that looks like this. In very hot weathers, it can expand and then destroy the railroad. If we think now about two dimensions, well, we have the same thing. The variation area is now the initial area times 2 times the coefficient of thermal expansion times the variation of temperature. Why we have this number 2 here? Well, if you think in an area of a material and we expand it, it expanding in two directions, but it's the same material. So that's why we use a 2, we multiply everything here by 2. We can bring the same concepts, the same logic to 3 dimensions. So the variation in volume is the initial volume times 3 times the thermal expansion coefficient times the temperature. And it's the same logic, we have 3-dimensional expansional, so we multiply this coefficient by 3 because it expands in 3 directions. Well, let's practice a little bit now. So the following graph shows how the length of a metallic bar changes in function of its temperature. So in the y-axis we have length in centimeters, and in the x-axis we have the temperature in degrees Celsius. So what is the coefficient of linear expansion for this metallic bar? Well, we can see here in the graph the variation in length. It starts at 500 centimeters and ends at 500.1 centimeters. So the variation is 0.1 centimeters. And also from the graph, the variation in temperature is 200 degrees Celsius. Now, if you rearrange the formula for the linear expansion, we can isolate the coefficient of linear expansion. And inserting the values here, the variation in length is 0.1 centimeters, the initial length is 500 centimeters, and the variation in temperature is 200. And it gives us this coefficient of linear expansion of 1. Now it's your turn. Think if a bar of the same material has 200 meters length at 10 degrees Celsius. Determine its final length when heated up to 110 degrees Celsius. So do your calculations and comment, type your answers in the comment section. Thank you.
If you're looking for similar topics, check out our other videos and don't forget to subscribe.